Hi. Did you ever feel like giving up on something you so strongly wanted, on something you so strongly wanted to accomplish or to have in your life, and you just felt like all hope is lost? You fell into despair. Well, I hope to share with you insights from Rabbetzin Yemima Mizrahi to help us not lose hope. After Moshe Rabbeinu fulfilled his mission in this world, he begged Hashem to allow him to enter Eretz Israel. It says that he begged him, he asked to enter the Promised Land 515 times. He kept on asking Hashem, and Hashem, in response to after the 515 times, Hashem answered Moshe, "Enough, don't speak to me about this anymore." It is written in Devarim 3:26. Why did Moshe Rabbeinu stop? Because he's Moshe Rabbeinu. He's Hashem's loyal shepherd and he will do his bidding. If he would have prayed one more time, Hashem would have granted him the request that Moshe Rabbeinu wanted, which is to enter the Promised Land. However, we're not Moshe Rabbeinu. We do not have a clear, direct relationship with Hashem, our God, where He speaks to us openly, like He did with Moshe Rabbeinu. So when do you know that, there's just almost no way out? How can you go on anymore? How can you handle this? When you are in so much pain, when you are almost just, we don't want to say the word depressed, but when you feel like there's all hope is lost, when you don't have a way out, just know that with one more prayer, your request will be granted. And we learn this from our Moshe Rabbeinu. Our sages teach us that there's a certain amount of prayers that if you ask Hashem a certain amount of time, the answer will be no. And each prayer is different. You can pray for different things. For one thing that you want, you may ask Hashem for just a few times, for one time, for thousands of times, for hundreds of times. We don't know. The only thing we do know is that we have to keep trying and never to give up because we don't know. We need to show Hashem how badly we really want something and never, ever, ever to give up. We learned this from our holy sages. Rashi tells us that Moshe Rabbeinu prayer to be allowed to enter Eretz Israel, not because of his merit and his greatness and his great deeds, but because of matnas chinam. What does that mean? Matnas chinam means an unearned gift. Moshe Rabbeinu, our loyal shepherd, the leader of the Jewish people, he did not think he deserved to enter the Promised Land. If he didn't feel that way, and who are we to really ask Hashem that we deserve anything? So, our sages teach us this in order so that we can internalize a powerful lesson in life. Sinas chinam means baseless hatred, hating others for no reason, hating the Jewish people for no reason, hating others for no apparent reason. Matnas chinam is an unearned gift. In other words, in order to rectify Sinas chinam, which is why we are in Galus, we need to rectify it with asking Hashem for undeserved gifts, for matnas chinam, for giving unconditional love to Hashem, for asking Him that, Hashem, maybe I have wronged, maybe I have sinned, maybe I'm not as great as you want me to be yet. I really hope to try, I really hope to continue. And give me, Hashem, this unearned gift of whatever you want, whether it's health, wealth, whatever salvation, what you're looking for, good children, well-behaved children, a beautiful marriage, finding your bashert, your destined, your soulmate, whatever it is that you want, you ask Hashem continuously, nonstop, for an undeserved gift, for a free gift. When we ask Hashem to give us a gift, we're constantly grateful to Him for what we have. Just think about it. When you have your own children or children in general, when children come to a teacher or a parent, when they're constantly grateful for everything the teacher or parent gives them, they naturally, the adult wants to do much more for that child. So in the same way, we have to understand our relationship with Hashem. When we are constantly grateful to Hashem, sincere, constant, genuine gratitude. It's not just words coming out of your mouth. You really have to think about it and really mean it. Is it hard to do it all the time? Yes, but more and more is better than none at all. So may we gather the inner strength to collect ourselves and never give up on the power that Hashem has to grant our request. Good luck, Leah Abramov, being and becoming.